More than 1,000 military veterans who were sent there in the 1950s to watch nuclear bomb tests have won a key battle for compensation. They're suffering the effects of radiation, but many are so ill they may not live to see a resolution.
Emerging from the Supreme Court, some of the nuclear test veterans and the solicitor who's fought their case.
The veterans have fought for many years for justice, and this is a step on the way. The government has steadfastly denied veterans the opportunity to have justice before they end their lives.
Veteran David Harmon's son was born with deformities and died after 5 months. He believes the nuclear tests he witnessed in the 50s were responsible and blames the Ministry of Defence.
Of course, while we were there, it was really top secret, so we weren't allowed to tell anybody anything. Quite right, you know. Since then, they've changed. They're not our friends anymore, the MOD.
Bomb away.
Britain's nuclear testing was carried out on Christmas Island in the South Pacific in the 50s. More than 1,000 servicemen say exposure to radiation has led to ill health such as cancer. The Ministry of Defence maintains no causal link can be proved. The Supreme Court's decision today overturns an appeal court ruling that 9 out of 10 test cases had been brought too late to be heard.
Application for permission to appeal is granted, but might I just emphasise this is only an application for permission to appeal. The court would not wish to raise false optimism in what are obviously some very difficult cases.
If this case had failed, it would have effectively spelled the end of the line for the veterans' compensation claim. But this ruling gives them hope, with an appeal to be held later this year. For now then, their fight goes on.
Neil Connery, 10 News.